Now we will learn how to record prepayments from customers. These advance payments from customers are also referred to as customer deposits. There are two methods of recording prepayments from customers. In this video, we will learn about the first one. The first method uses the receive payments window. Now, what will happen when you use the receive payments window to record an advance payment from a customer? Well, the open invoice report will show a negative number for that customer's prepayment. The customer balance detail will also show a decrease in the customer's balance for that same particular advanced payment. The bad news is there is no indication of the customer's prepaid in the trial balance. Of course, the accounts receivable account will decrease, but there is no separate account in the general ledger to show the total advance payments from all customers. For example, on February 25th, Alan paid us $2,000 in advance for 20 video hours to be done on February 26th, which is a future date. And of course, he paid us with check number 6161. For this, we will use the receive payments window. When we use the receive payments window, we record this transaction like we would record any other unapplied credit. It will show as a negative number on the open invoice report until it is applied to a future invoice. This is what Alan's open invoice section looks like before we record the advanced payment. We open the payment window and put in the information. We choose Alan. Of course, I usually suggest you collapse the ribbon if you're not using anything in the ribbon. He paid us with check number 6161. The day he paid us in this example is February 25. And of course, the money amount that he paid was $2,000. When I push the tab key, the computer thinks that I am paying for invoice number 13, but I am not. Therefore, we must remove the check mark from invoice number 13 and don't place the check mark anywhere. That's because this payment from check number 6161 is not for invoice number 13. It will be for a future invoice. By the way, don't forget to change the deposit to undeposited funds, because this is not money that will go directly into the bank. This is a check Alan gave us that we are waiting to deposit. So again, QuickBooks will place the check mark here on number 13 because it assumes that's the one he's paying for. Remove it and make sure there's no check marks at all when you click Save and Close. You will get this warning message. You have a payment credit. You could print the credit memo if you want and send it to Alan, or you could just click OK and make sure that you have that credit, but it's still not yet applied. When we click OK, we look at the open invoice report and we see the payment is now showing on the open invoice report. This is the first time that a payment showed up on the open invoice report. And as you can see, it's a negative number and it makes the balance go down, and it will stay here until we apply that payment to the future invoice. Now, let's imagine on February 26th, Holden did the 20 video hours for Alan that Alan paid for the day before February 25th. First, record the invoice. Make sure you put this as invoice number 21. Secondly, click Apply Credits from the ribbon. Then, choose the payment to apply just like you were applying any other credit. So, we open the invoice window. Of course, I like to make it small enough to fit the screen. Put the date, February 26th. Make sure that you change this to invoice number 21, because recording credit memos changes the pattern of the invoice number. So you have to put invoice number 21 yourself. Choose Alan, And of course, the quantity is 20. The item is video. And you can see the total is $6,000. Now, we made the invoice, but now we have to apply the credit. When you click Apply Credit, QuickBooks will prompt you to save the invoice before you apply the credit. So click Yes. The Apply Credits window opens up just like it did in the previous video. Notice the only credit that's available in this case is from check number 6161. If there were several, you would have to choose the credit and then click Done. But in this case, the credit is already chosen for us because it's the only one. When we click Done, we notice the balance of the invoice automatically goes down to $4,000. When we click Save and Close, we look back at the open invoice and we see that the credit from the prepayment of $2,000 from check number 6161 is now gone. It's no longer in the open invoice. And you also notice that this invoice number 21, which the original amount was $6,000, now shows up as $4,000. If we double click on invoice number 21, and then we go to reports and check the history of this, you can see that it was created on February 26th, but then you applied a payment that you had received on February 25th, and that explains why the balance is $4,000.